kid up to the top rope, Jack. What's... And a drop kick off the top rope, catching the number one Frenchman, and Rene Goulet's in big trouble. Davey Boy Smith catches...
All right, this week's featured match, the British Bulldogs, the Dynamite Kid, and Davey Boy Smith going up against Barry O and Rene Goulet. Hello again, everybody. This is Gene Okerlund in the World Wrestling Federation Sports Control Center with another edition of All American Wrestling. By the way, the big one coming up, 1 o'clock sharp today, WrestleMania, coast to coast, border to border, 24 foreign countries, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time. They're talking about it all over this country, literally all over the globe. By the way, today on our program, you're going to be seeing Mad Maxine. Here's a gal I've talked about. In addition, Big John Studd to lock up with Jim Young in Piper's Pit leading up to WrestleMania. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and Cowboy Bob Orton. Of course, the colleagues of Rowdy Roddy Piper. Greg the Hammer Valentine, the current reigning Intercontinental Champ, will also be on our program this week, and it is going to be something else, I can guarantee you that. Stay tuned, fans. We're going to get you up to the ring for exciting action from the World Wrestling Federation after these important messages. Don't go away. Stay tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be a tag team match. Introducing first, from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 235 pounds, Bobby O. His partner from Nice, France, weighing 230 pounds, the number one Frenchman, Rene Goulet. Their opponents, now about to enter the ring area, the British Bulldogs. First, from Leeds, England, weighing 240 pounds, Davey Boy Smith. His partner from Manchester, England, weighing 225 pounds, the Dynamite Kid.
What a tremendous tag team combination, the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith and the Dynamite Kid.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, I haven't had a chance. This will be my first chance to see them in live action. They're both put together, and I mean they're put together, and I've heard a lot of things about them, that they do some remarkable things in that ring, Jack. I'm interested to see this match right now.
Their opponents, the number one Frenchman, Rene Goulet, and Barry O. There's the bell, the match officially underway. Rene Goulet going against the Dynamite Kid.
And Goulet working that leg in on the arm bar and twisting around on it. Rene Goulet caught the Dynamite Kid in a quick arm drag and now has the arm bar on it. And did you see how quick the Dynamite Kid did that nip up to his feet?
Jesse, I've had the opportunity many, many times of watching not only the Dynamite Kid, but also Davey Boy Smith in action. And I'll tell you something, boy, they are two exciting professional wrestlers.
Goulet again trying to go back to that arm bar, I should say. Much too early to try for a pin right here. Dynamite Kid bridging, and look at Goulet. Goulet can't knock him down off the bridge. The guy looks like he's got about a 19 or 20 inch neck on him, Jack.
What a tremendous bridge in there by the Dynamite Kid. Boy, I'll tell you, you talk about a man that uses every ounce of strength to his advantage. Both the combination of Davey Boy Smith and the Dynamite Kid.
Well, the Dynamite Kid just did a real tricky little monkey flip on Rene Goulet, the number one Frenchman, and now he's tagging in Davey Boy Smith. And Davey Boy is definitely put together, Jack.
Well, they call him the British Bulldogs, and boy, in that ring, in that square circle, Bulldogs they are.
Davey Boy Smith with a side headlock on Barry O. Barry O, I've never seen before either, so I'm getting an opportunity to see three wrestlers tonight I've never seen. Big tackle, down goes Barry O, drop down. And he reverses that hip toss. Beautiful move by Davey Boy Smith. Barry O got out of the way of the elbow. Smith gets out of the way of the elbow. And an arm drag. What a match we're seeing here, Jack.
Boy, you talk about excitement, fast-moving excitement, and the men moving with ultrasonic speed in that ring. What a combination.
Tag out, and in comes the Dynamite Kid. Catches Barry O with a headbutt and a shot to the jaw. Picks him up, big body slam, trying for a cover. Nope, just got a one count, Jack. Snapmare. And there's a combination hold. Very interesting. And in comes Rene Goulet and puts a boot on the back of the Dynamite Kid.
That's Rene Goulet coming to the aid of his tag team partner. There's a tag Goulet coming in right now, going against Davey Boy Smith.
Goulet stepping behind, but Smith coming out with an armbar. Goulet with a kick out. Nice move by Rene Goulet. Collar elbow hookup. Backs into the corner, and Davey Boy tags out to the Dynamite Kid. Big forearm to the side of Goulet's head. Front suplex, and down goes Rene Goulet. And here goes the Dynamite Kid up to the top rope, Jack. And a drop kick off the top rope, catching the number one Frenchman, and Rene Goulet's in big trouble. Davey Boy Smith catches Barry O with a drop kick off the top rope.
Oh, you talk about double teaming. You talk about a combination working well together in that ring. You're seeing it right now.
Big tackle. Miss with the elbow. Over the top. And Barry O catches him with a big clothesline.
Good move in there.
The Dynamite Kid's in trouble.
Good move in there by Barry O, and a miss.
Tag off. Davey Boy Smith in. Wheeling Barry O into the ropes. Big back body drop. And a tag out to Rene Goulet.
Well, the fans loving this match. You talk about fast-moving excitement. Look at this.
And a power body slam, and Rene Goulet is down and not quite out. In comes Barry O, and he catches
and
him.
And a tag.
What is happening here? Over the top, steps on. Whoa, what a move. Never seen anything like it. Jack, I don't even know what to call it.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable, Jack. Listen to the crowd. Oh, you talk about excitement. The British Bulldogs. Wow.
Jack, I got to wait for the instant replay. I don't even know what to call that. I'm going to have to catch up with the British Bulldogs and find out what you call that. I've never seen anything like it before, Jack. Amazing.
Unbelievable.
The winners of the match, the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith and the Dynamite Kid.
Well, I believe my colleague Jack Reynolds used the adjective unbelievable. I'm going to say awesome on behalf of the Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith. Certainly, they are going to be a tag team. I love that high flying, by the way. But they are going to be a tag team to be reckoned with in weeks and months to come here in the World Wrestling Federation. Fans, wait a minute. Was that the chair? Did you do that again? Knock that off. Thank you very much. Fans, stay tuned. A very special update on tap. In addition, you're going to be seeing Big John Studd, as he calls himself, the self-proclaimed giant, John Studd, to meet Jimmy Young at a special interview. It's just moments away. More exciting All-American Wrestling right around the corner.
Update this week is the Junkyard Dog, wrestling's most charismatic member, a man who has dedicated himself to his profession. The Junkyard Dog may like to dance, but he's in deadly earnest when he comes to the ring. Let us watch the Junkyard Dog play and work a little bit.
Started this dance in my neighborhood. Now everybody's doing it because it feels so good. All you need is a partner that know how to move, and the rest are real easy. Just dig the groove, and when you get yourself started, it's hard to stop. You just go for your partner.
It is obvious that the Junkyard Dog likes to play a little bit. It is also very obvious the Junkyard Dog has worked hard.
This is a one-fall contest. Introducing first to my left, the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. And he represents from Los Angeles, California, weighing 367 pounds, Big John Studd.
Holding in his hand, $15,000 and a bag of hair off the head of the dummy, Andre the so-called Giant.
His opponent from Tampa, Florida, weighing 254 pounds, Jim Young.
Jim Young.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have been told by Big John Studd to Mr. Young, if you can slam Big John Studd, the $15,000 prize is yours.
Oh my goodness, would these fans be ecstatic if Jim Young slammed Big John Studd? Here he goes, trying to get the big man up. And Studd sort of sits out on, I guess, the $15,000 is safe again. Drop kick, backs Big John up. Goes for it again, oh, look at that. Ooh, forearm across the back, Big John Studd.
That was smart what Young did. He couldn't slam him, so he drop kicked, trying to get him off balance, and then tried to slam him. Cut him off about a foot, but that was it.
Covered by Big John. Yank of the hair. As we said earlier on, Andre scheduled to join us, but in the frame of mind that the Giant was in, no one would sign a contract to face Andre one-on-one. And Big John, rather sportingly, I might say, very much look. Wait a minute. Andre takes his jacket off. Andre coming into the ring. Andre through the ropes. Big John Studd hammering on Andre. Studd hammering. Big John and Andre going toe to toe. Oh my goodness, look at this. Two giants in there, hammering, going back and forth. Ciampa, oh no, that's Big John. Andre reaching. Bobby Heenan keeping Big John Studd at bay. They were going at it like two animals, two giant-sized animals.
Look at this,
here
coming
he comes
back.
He's coming back.
Heenan's pushing him away. Heenan says no.
Oh. That's an angry giant. Justifiably so. A very angry giant.
But look at Studd. Studd wants to go in. It's Heenan. Heenan is pushing him back. Say no, no. Get back to the dressing room. But Andre, look at him. He's waiting. He wants him to come back.
The $15,000 and the bag of hair in the hand. Big John Studd as Andre wants John Studd to step back into the ring. Boy, is he angry.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this bout, as a result of a disqualification for outside interference, Big John Studd.
Big John gets the Duke. But obviously, it would appear as though Andre set up Big John Studd just so he could get his hands on him here.
And he's not interested in the $15,000 either, no, Andre. He just wants John Studd, and he wants to just give him the licking of his life.
Listen to these fans. Andre. Well, one of these days, we'll find out who the real giant is. Let's go back to the video replay.
Look at this. Now, he sees Andre. Andre's coming in. Studd tries to Pearl Harbor, so to speak, and he's got him going a little bit, but watch this, in a second, we're going to see Andre come back and gives him a big chop, and look at that. After a headbutt, and then I think a second chop, which sends Andre right, John Studd goes right down to the canvas, and this week gets up, and here it comes right now. And look at this, here comes Studd, he rolls up into the rope, out of the ring, and this is where Ian says, let's get out of here, let's not have anything to do with this.
This Sunday afternoon, it's getting all ready to erupt WrestleMania. This Sunday afternoon, 1 p.m., giant screen, closed circuit TV, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time. What a card. Hulk Hogan teams up with Mr. T, Jimmy Superfly Snuka in their corner. Their opponents will be, by the way, Rowdy Roddy Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff with Ace Cowboy Bob Orton in their corner. In addition, Andre the Giant puts his entire career on the line when he meets Big John Studd. Studd putting $15,000 in cold hard cash out in this challenge match.
In addition, Intercontinental Champion Greg the Hammer Valentine to be challenged by the Junkyard Dog. It is all going to be part of WrestleMania this Sunday afternoon, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time with a 1 p.m. start. Leilani Kai with the Fabulous Moolah in her corner to meet Wendy Richter with Cyndi Lauper in her corner. All right, come on in if you would please, Cyndi Lauper. You know, lightning can strike twice in the same place. Yes, tremendous controversy, perhaps injustice, but it could conceivably happen again.
That's right. It could conceivably happen that Moolah goes down one more time.
Right.
Let me tell you something, Mean Gene. I get so mad at Moolah that sometimes when I look at her, I want to do anything to her. I tell you, I mean, I'm not a wrestler. I'm glad that there's another woman manager in wrestling, female wrestling, because it helps female wrestling, but that Moolah is a chump. That Moolah is a chump, and this time I'm not going to pull out a little punch for her. I'm really going to give it to her, but I want to keep her out of the ring and away from her. You know why? Because Lani Kai is not half the wrestler that my girl Wendy is.
Ladies and gentlemen, this coming Sunday, WrestleMania, and the ladies' title will be on the line. Don't you dare miss it.
Yes, I know you're at Madison Square Garden. What do you prefer? Should I call you Lee? Should I call you Liberace? Mr. Liberace? Lee, okay, fine, we'll settle for that. Paul Orndorff's robes, I have no idea, Lee, where he gets them made. If I find out, I'll give you a call.
Gene, come on.
Hold. Well, so long. I'm sorry, I get carried away in conversation. I was just talking with Liberace, the official timekeeper for WrestleMania, 1 o'clock, coast to coast on closed circuit TV. I've been waiting for this one a couple of weeks now. Let's go up to the ring and see newcomer to the World Wrestling Federation, Mad Maxine.
This is a one-fall event. First of all, to my right, from Oklahoma, weighing 140 pounds, Susan Starr. Now may I introduce to you the manager, former ladies' champion, the Fabulous Moolah. And ladies and gentlemen, she represents 6 feet, 4 inches tall, Mad Maxine.
My goodness, what is this? I don't believe I've ever seen a lady quite that large.
I sure have not. 6'4", that's unreal. I've never seen anybody, a girl wrestle with that kind of an hairdo either. Look at that.
She is a most unusual, size-wise, most impressive individual. And a Fabulous Moolah. The manager, Mad Maxine. Look at her. Uh-huh. A little lunge there. 6'4". She looks like she's about 7'5" in there.
Really?
Compared to Susan Starr.
My goodness, she is big.
Maxine. Now, Maxine a little slow on the mark. Takedown by Susan Starr. Maxine quickly kicking out.
So far, Susan's playing it very smart. She's making her miss. She's keeping herself out of trouble. Makes her miss, and then, like, she did not get behind her for a back row. Let's see if she can keep it up.
Look how long the arms are here on that back.
Oh,
powerful woman.
Yeah, I was going to say, that demonstrated quite a bit of strength the way she just pushed that Susan Starr off like that.
Locking up again, and well, that's what you get for locking up with Maxine, I guess.
Wow, she is strong. She is strong.
Nice maneuver by Susan Starr.
All right, nice drop toe hold. See what she did? She dropped toe hold, caught both of her legs, took her down, and she's got things under control.
One thing Susan Starr must do now is stay away from the proximity of the ropes over there where Moolah is.
Absolutely. Stay away is right. Keep her toward the center of the ring. Uh-oh, here comes the hair pull.
Maxine having problems escaping the hold. That is unusual here.
Well, yeah, boy, I'll say. Never seen anything like it. But Susan Starr so far, well, here comes a big monkey flip, watch. Ooh.
Yeah, nicely done by Maxine.
You know, when you get monkey flipped by someone like this, so that Maxine, so tall, it's like taking a body slam. Oh, look
wow.
at this.
Very, very. Oh.
These kind of blows will take their effect on Susan Starr. Oh,
and
my.
Again, way up, and again, way down. Woo. Moolah likes what she sees. Maxine, what's she going to do with her
oh
hair?
Oh, boy, suplex. Look at this.
Woo. Wow. From way up high. Cover by Maxine, and a three count.
Wow. That's a long way down. He's 6'4".
Fabulous Moolah getting her thing in. Ah, Maxine, the latest protege of the fabulous Moolah.
Here is your winner, Mad Maxine.
Mad Maxine. Look at that kisser on her.
Phew. Good hair.
I know some male wrestlers that would have a little reluctance to step in the ring with Mad Maxine.
So.
Different, but I'll tell you what, you cannot deny a whole lot of talent in that 6'4" frame as Mad Maxine gets the Duke in the World Wrestling Federation. I'll tell you, she is something else. That hair. I said hair. I didn't say pear. I said hair. Is something else. Fans, stay tuned. Rowdy Roddy Piper, the very controversial host of Piper's Pit. Special guests will be Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, and of course, their bodyguard, collective bodyguard, Ace Cowboy Bob Orton. It's right around the corner, right here on All American Wrestling. Fans, stay tuned. He is piping hot. I can only be talking about Rowdy Roddy Piper after these important messages. All right, at 1 p.m. this afternoon, it is WrestleMania, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time. I should remind you, this particular program, this extravaganza will not, I repeat, will not be seen on cable or commercial television at a later date. This afternoon, closed circuit, the only time, 1 p.m., you're going to be able to see WrestleMania.
And I'd like you to take a look at this WrestleMania that's going to happen this Sunday afternoon. What we got here is what we found hanging around the restroom. You see, we have a new feature now in Piper's Pit. It's called the hot seat. Now, I want you to take a look at these two fellas. Now, this is happening this Sunday afternoon. Don't they? Is that not a Rembrandt right there? Just take a look at that. That's exactly where those two folks belong. But no, in the hot seat. We don't want to disappoint them, Paul, do we? We got something for each one, huh? A little something for Mr.
Oh, how about a banana, Mr. T, you souped-up spider monkey? Yeah. Oh, have a banana. Oh, I love it. Yeah. How about Hogan? How about Hulk Hogan? How about the banana?
Oh, my goodness, we have something else. We don't want to leave them with egg on their face. Come the garden, do it. No, there you go.
Lovely.
You see, these are the two heroes that you've been admiring and looking so forward to, that me and Mr. Wonderful, with my bodyguard Ace, is going to fight this Sunday afternoon. How is your arm?
Oh, Roddy, it's terrible.
Your arm still hurts you, huh?
Hello, goodbye. You see, this Sunday afternoon, it's them that's going to be in the hot seat, not us, brother.
Roddy Piper, certainly very condescending and very patronizing when it comes to Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and Ace Cowboy Bob Orton. However, I think at 1 o'clock in WrestleMania today, I think Roddy Piper, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and Cowboy Bob Orton, all three of them, may have a second thought or two regarding the likes of Hulk Hogan and Mr. T from the A-Team. In their corner, I do want to point out, will be none other than Jimmy Superfly Snuka. It is the largest, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time, only to be seen on closed-circuit TV. It will not be shown on cable or commercial television at a later date. Preparing this past week in the Big Apple, New York City, let's go to a workout with Hulk Hogan and Mr. T.
You know, Mr. T, this is New York City, just like I told you, brother. Hulk country, your kind of people, Daddy. Just like the south side of Chicago. The biggest buildings, the wildest people. Check it out, the Empire State Building. And back there, check those two buildings out, man. The World Trade Center.
Dig it, man. Just like us, man. It's tough and big and strong. I know that, man, but I want to see the other part of New York, man. I want to show you Central Park, man.
What do you mean? What do you
We're going to Central Park, man, to take up the muggers. If we clean up the muggers in Central Park, we ready for a pipe on Orndorff. Every mugger we see in Central Park, we run along, we jump on them, beat them up, make it decent. For decent people around here. That's what we want to do.
You know, T, this is a different kind of training. That street fighting you've been telling
That's
me about,
That's what I'm going to tell you about
right?
Here. You've been teaching me wrestling. There. I want to show you how to street fight.
Show me the way,
All right,
man.
We got to do it, man.
Let's go.
Right, let's go, man.
Come
let's go.
On, let's
come
do.
On, man. Come on.
Come on. Get behind me, man. Hit move. Come on, Hulk, man. Come on, Hulk, baby. Get your elbows. Elbows. Come on,
Daddy. Keep moving.
Training with you. I never knew what it was like, brother. I never knew how heavy you could get in the combat zone. But when you taught me about kicking, punching, and especially that guerrilla warfare,
that's
I
right,
think
man.
We're ready, dude.
Okay, no holds barred, man.
No wrestling holds, man. No wrestling holds.
You got me strong, man, for lifting that iron, man, and I'm ready. I'm going to use everything you taught me, man, you know. And I want you to use everything I've been telling you. Play dirty, elbows, knees. Stand with them there, anything, man, because they want to get dirty. I ain't forgot, man. We've been training for 6 weeks, man. And we ready now, man. All these people, they want to see us get down, man.
They want it. You know, it's just like the Chi-Town where you're from, brother. New York City. These are survivors. We're survivors. And the thing is, T, that guerrilla warfare, we got to remember, man.
That's right, man. We're saying, homie, die the tiger. That's your main soul.
Die the tiger. You taught me, brother.
That's right, man.
You taught me to stay hungry.
We forget nothing, man, you know. I remember what they did to me, man. Jumped on me in the back and whatnot. I mean, when they slapped Sidney and whatnot, I ain't forgot that, man.
You know, but it goes far. farther than that. I'll never forget the sight I saw. Down on my back, Mr. T up there directing traffic. They were running like cowards, brother.
That's right, man, because you're my buddy. I don't believe nobody can stop us, man.
You know now.
That's right, we're going to do it, man.
We're going to do it.
I think my man, the plane's going to be packed up less than 24 hours, man. Everybody going to be hollering. Women, children, everybody. All your fans all across the world in theaters and whatnot. And we can't disappoint them.
One thing, they want to see it. I'm going to look into your eyes. You look into mine.
That's right,
you'll
man.
Stay hungry.
We're going to be ready.
A 1 o'clock start this afternoon. It's called WrestleMania, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time. Roddy Piper, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff to meet Hulk Hogan and Mr. T. In addition, tag team champions Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo to meet the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkoff for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championships. Big John Studd puts up 15 grand. Andre the Giant says he'll retire if he doesn't body slam Big John Studd this afternoon. Leilani Kai, ladies champion, the Fabulous Moolah in her corner to meet Wendy Richter with Cyndi Lauper in her corner. And Greg the Hammer Valentine, the current reigning Intercontinental Champ, to be challenged by the Junkyard Dog. Speaking of the Junkyard Dog, stay tuned. He's going to be coming up. I beg your pardon, Greg the Hammer Valentine will be here in a moment. Real.
Greg Valentine, it looks great. He's, comes right in with a knee, right in an elbow, right on Pompey. And now a big elbow right on top of the head, and Pompey right off the bat is in serious trouble. And now looks like Greg Valentine comes with a big, powerful slam. I'll tell you, this Greg Valentine, since he's won the Intercontinental title, he sure has been devastating. He's met and defeated all opponents thus far. And he has really been very, very aggressive. And right now, Pompey is feeling the might of Greg Valentine. Another big elbow top of the head, and now he's got a reversed chin lock. And Pompey has just got a lot of problems.
Valentine thus far maintaining his control. And Greg the Hammer certainly wants to hang on to the Intercontinental Championship for a long, long time. This, of course, a non-title matchup. And in the front face lock, Valentine back to the corner by Mr. Pompeo. Series of shoulder blocks taking its toll on Greg Valentine. And to the buckle. Uh-oh, running right into the knee lift of Mr. Valentine. Very cagey, crafty individual, Bruno.
Well, he certainly is. Very, very cagey. But Pompey telegraphed that coming in. You can't make mistakes like that against a guy like Valentine. Valentine isn't champion for not being too sharp in there. And you just don't do what Pompey just did. If you're going to whip a guy like Valentine to the buckle, you have to be right behind him and come up and hit him. Ooh, those elbows that he throws. Those smashing elbows on the chest. I'll tell you, I don't know if too many people they can do it with the force of a Greg Valentine.
Yes, indeed. One of the reasons why they call Greg the Hammer is now back into the ring, or almost. Now down to the canvas again. Look at Jimmy Hart. Oh, he loves what he sees.
Well, Jimmy Hart says he's got one Intercontinental Champion here, and now in Bundy, he's looking for another title. Those are his goals.
And he has, of course, waiting in the wings as well, the Anvil, Jim Neidhart. This Jimmy Hart is quite a force to reckon with in the World Wrestling Federation in such a short length of time.
He's got himself such a stable of wrestlers among the best that exist, if not the best, really.
Valentine going toe-to-toe with a competitor now and back to the corner and trying to get the Valentine out. Nicely done. Uh-oh, ran right into the knee again. Mr. Valentine continuing to assert his authority in the ring. Compelling. That's too far. I don't think you'll get him here. We have two. Maybe. I think he could have had him.
That's why he didn't get him. He could have got him. Suplex like that, you know, it can knock the wind right out of you.
Uh-oh, fans about ringside not liking what they see as Mr. Valentine drops a knee into the midsection area. Attempting apparently to rearrange the facial area. Uh-oh, Mr. Valentine going to work on the legs now.
He digs those knees right in the back of the thigh of an opponent. Look at that. And pretty soon you'll see, pretty soon he'll weaken that leg and he'll go for his four-figure. It's four-figure lock. Oh. One-legged grab here. Well, not quite. He hasn't quite turned him over. But he's just working on that leg just to weaken it before he puts the hold on.
Valentine, more of a methodical type individual. He grinds you, wear you down little by little, and known to work on the legs. And then from there, when he sets you up for that figure four leg lock, I don't think there's an escape, is there?
No. Once he puts that on, forget about it. I've never seen anybody escape.
Valentine, perching there on top of the rope. Ooh, wow. Valentine giving the signal. Dragging a carcass out there to the middle of the ring. Valentine stepping over, getting ready to apply the figure four leg lock, and he locks it right down. And that spells defeat. The Pompel is Greg the Hammer Valentine, and his manager, Jimmy Hart. Once again, obtain yet another victory.
It's WrestleMania this Sunday afternoon, 1 p.m. sharp, closed circuit. Giant screen, closed circuit TV in the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time. What a card. Hulk Hogan and Mr. T with Jimmy Superfly Snuka in their corner to meet Rowdy Roddy Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Ace Cowboy Bob Orton in their corner. Special guest announcer, I must repeat, will be baseball great Billy Martin. Special guest referee, former heavyweight boxing champion Muhammad Ali. The ladies champion, Leilani Kai, with the fabulous Moolah in her corner to meet Wendy Richter with rock singing sensation and Grammy winner Cyndi Lauper in her corner. Andre the Giant and Big John Studd to collide. Andre the Giant putting his entire career on the line. John Studd, $15,000 in cold hard cash. In addition on that card, Intercontinental Champ Greg the Hammer Valentine to be challenged by none other than the Junkyard Dog. It is going to be an absolutely fantastic card. One you will not want to miss, either at Madison Square Garden or on Closed Circuit TV, 1 p.m. this Sunday afternoon. They're calling it WrestleMania, the biggest wrestling spectacular of all time. Captain Louis Albano, I'm going to prevail upon you. Your man, the current tag team champions of the world, Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo, to be challenged by a very tough combination, I might add, in the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkov.
Gene, when we took the titles, we vowed that we would take on the best in the world, and the best in the world right now, the top contenders, are the Sheik and Volkov. So we're staying here, we're staying behind our promise, we're going to get in with my two champions, and we do contemplate a rough, tough match. But on this card, Gene, I believe with the support of the people, and I believe with the ability of my champions, we're going to go all the way. We're going to be victorious, we contemplate a victory.
You know, I should point out, Barry, Mike, Lou, this is going to be seen, of course, across the country and around the world. 24 foreign countries. Gentlemen, a lot of added pressure. Unreal. Just the fact that the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkov on this particular occasion are the challengers, Mike Rotundo.
You know what I mean, Gene? I hope that they are showing this match of all matches in Iran. Because on this night in Madison Square Garden, where...
On this afternoon in Madison Square Garden. Right.
It doesn't... There's no other place
maybe
that I'd rather be
Iran.
Because the Sheik is going to be our hostage on that day. On that afternoon. And Barry and I have worked hard for this. We're coming after the Sheik and Volkov with everything we have on a the biggest ever wrestling day in the history of professional wrestling.
I thank you very much. Very well stated, Mike Rotundo. Barry Windham, your thoughts just hours away. The big title defense for Mike
That's
and
right.
yourself.
You know, WrestleMania, they named it right. It's the biggest thing ever in professional wrestling. And right now, Mike Rotundo and I are not going to let this day pass by without making something momentous of it.
Unreal, Jim.
These tag team titles are going on the line against the Russian and the Iranian, and we're going to show them just exactly what it's like to fight two Americans, two red-blooded Americans born in the USA, and we're going to take it to them. Give it to them our best.
Well, it all comes down to 1 o'clock today, WrestleMania, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time from the World Wrestling Federation. Let me run down the action one final time for you. Still time for you to get in your car and get down to a location in your city or town to see this gigantic spectacular. Hulk Hogan, heavyweight champion of the world, and Mr. T, with Jimmy Superfly Snuka in their corner to go against Rowdy Roddy Piper, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and Cowboy Bob Orton in their corner. World Tag Team Champions Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo this afternoon at 1,
to meet the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkov for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championships. Junkyard Dog challenges reigning Intercontinental Champ Greg the Hammer Valentine for that coveted title. Big John Studd puts up $15,000. Andre the Giant, on the other hand, puts up his entire career. Andre has stated if he does not body slam Big John Studd in WrestleMania this afternoon, he's going to hang it up. And that would be, indeed, quite a loss for all of us in the wrestling world. Leilani Kai, World Wrestling Federation Ladies Champ, the Fabulous Moolah in her corner, to be challenged by former champion Wendy Richter with none other than Cyndi Lauper in her corner, 1 p.m. this afternoon. This will not, I repeat one more time, this will not be seen on cable or commercial television at a later date. It's one time only, and it, I guarantee you, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be the biggest wrestling extravaganza you will ever see. I know the gang here at the studio, Rob, Vicky, Jim, Billy, Kevin, and Kerwin, we're all heading out for Madison Square Garden, and we're getting ready for this big, big event. Next week, a reminder on All-American Wrestling, teaming up for the first time, to my knowledge, Jimmy Superfly Snuka and Ricky Steamboat, latest addition to the World Wrestling Federation, to meet Goldie Rogers and Terry Gibbs in a big tag team affair. The Magnificent Morocco back in action here next week when he meets Quick Draw Rick McGraw. 458-pound King Kong Bundy will be on our card next week. Jim the Anvil Neidhart to lock up with Special Delivery Jones out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. That particular match taking place at Madison Square Garden a couple of weeks ago. And a new feature in the World Wrestling Federation, Jesse Ventura's Body Shop. I can hardly wait. Will be coming up next week. The Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith, collectively known as the British Bulldogs, to be part of the action as they square off against Matt Bourne and Mr. X. Indeed, it is going to be a big, big afternoon for WrestleMania and a big one next year on All-American Wrestling. For all of us in the World Wrestling Federation Sports Control Center, this is Gene Okerlund saying we'll see you at WrestleMania back here next week. Have a good one. So long, everybody.